Good morning and welcome to the online classes being conducted by Bal Sadhana Group of Institution. Today we will start our new topic, that is narration or direct and indirect speech. Narration. Narration means the art of expressing the spoken words of a speaker. Narration means the art of expressing the spoken words of a speaker. We can reveal narration in two ways. We can express our views in two ways. One is direct speech, another is indirect speech. So, the art of expressing the spoken words of a speaker is known as narration. And to reveal narration, we have two ways. First, direct speech. Second, another one, indirect speech. Direct speech. The actual words of the speaker are used in direct speech. The actual words of the speaker are used. Or when you report what somebody has told you or what you have heard, in this way it is called direct speech. The actual words of the speaker are used by repeating the words of the speaker. It describes or repeated the speaker's word exactly. The rule for direct speech or the direct speech means the actual words of the speaker are used by repeating the words of the speaker. It describes or repeated the speaker's word exactly. Points about direct speech. First, the reported speech is put within the inverted commas. The reported speech is put within the inverted commas. Direct speech sentence has two parts. Direct speech sentence has two parts. One, outside the inverted commas or reporting verb, and the other within the inverted commas. Within the inverted commas, reported speech. So direct speech sentence has two parts, reported verb and reported speech. So one part is outside the inverted commas and the other within the inverted commas. So direct speech sentence have two parts, one outside the inverted commas, that is reported verb, and the other within the inverted commas, that is reported speech. Example, Madhu said, comma, inverted commas begin, I am doing my work, full stop, comma, closed. Outside the inverted commas, reporting verb. Within the inverted commas, reported speech. The reported speech begins with a capital letter. The reported speech begins with a capital letter. A comma is used. A comma is used to separate the reported speech. A comma is used to separate the reported speech from the reported verb. So, here are some points to put in mind about direct speech. They are, First, the reported speech is put within inverted commas. This, I am doing my work. These words are in inverted commas. Direct speech sentence has two parts. One outside the inverted commas, that is reported verb, and the other within the inverted commas, that is reported speech. The reported speech begins. The reported speech begins with a capital letter. A comma. There is comma. Listen, look here. There is comma after said. So, a comma is used to separate the reported speech from the reporting verb. So, next, indirect speech. When we give the substance of speaker speech in our own words. Listen, when we give the substance of speaker's speech in our own words, it becomes indirect speech. Or when we do not report what a person has said by using exactly the same word used by the speaker, we use what is it is called indirect speech. Instead of expressing speaker's comment directly, the speaker's words are modified and presented with proper change. Instead of expressing speaker's comments directly, the speaker's words are modified and presented with proper change. It involves reporting or describing what was said. Listen, indirect speech involves reporting or describing what was said. So, in indirect speech means when we give the substance of speaker speech in our own words, it becomes indirect speech. Instead of expressing speaker's comments directly, the speaker's words are modified and presented with proper change. It involves reporting or describing what was said. So, some points about indirect speech. The reported speech is not placed within inverted commas. The reported speech is not placed within inverted commas. No comma is placed after said. No comma is placed after said. The reported speech is introduced by the conjunction that. The reported speech is introduced by the conjunction that. The tense of the verb in the reported speech is changed from the present to the past. Let us see one example. The servant said, comma, inverted commas begin, tea is ready. Full stop, comma, closed. So, this speech is in inverted commas, then it means it is direct speech. Now, we will change this sentence from direct to indirect. The servant said that. The servant said that tea was ready. Full stop. So, in indirect, The reported speech is not placed within inverted commas. The reported speech is not placed within inverted commas. No comma is after said. No comma is placed after said. The reported speech is introduced. The reported speech is introduced by that. The tense of the verb in the reported speech is changed from the present to past. From the present to past. So, the servant said, comma, inverted commas begin, tea is ready, full stop, comma, closed. The servant said that tea was ready. So, when you report what somebody has told you or what you have heard in this way, it is called direct speech. And when we do not report what a person has said, by using exactly the same words used by the speaker, we use what is called the indirect speech. So, the servant said tea is ready. In this sentence, the actual words of the speaker are used. And in second sentence, the servant said that tea was ready. We give the substance of his speech in our own words. So, in sentence 1, this tea is ready is called the reported speech and the verb said. That introduces the reported speech is called reporting verb. Next, if reporting verb is in present, indefinite and future indefinite, if reporting verb is in present indefinite or future indefinite, then there is no change in the tense of reported speech. So, there is no change in the tense of reported speech. And says to become tells. So, let us see some examples. He says, comma, inverted commas begin. Suresh gets up in the morning. Full stop, comma, closed. He says that Suresh gets up in the morning. Second sentence. He says Suresh got up late. He says, comma, inverted commas begin. Suresh got up late. Full stop, comma, closed. He says that Suresh got up late. Full stop. He says, comma, inverted commas begin. Sadhna will get up early. Full stop, comma, closed. He says that Sadhna will get up early. Full stop. She says, I am learning a lesson. She says, I am learning a lesson. She says that she is learning a lesson. She says, they have learned a lesson. She says, comma, inverted commas begin. They have learned a lesson. Full stop, comma, closed. She says that they have learned a lesson. Full stop. She says to her mother, comma, inverted commas begin, the sweets are good. Full stop, comma, closed. She tells her mother that the sweets are good. Ram will say, comma, inverted commas begin, Rajan will tell a lie. Full stop, कॉमा क्लोज. राम विल से दैट, राजन विल टेल अ लाई. राम विल से कॉमा इन्वर्टेड कॉमास बिगिन, राजन टेल्स अ स्टोरी फुल स्टॉप कॉमा क्लोज. राम विल से दैट, राजन टेल्स अ स्टोरी फुल स्टॉप. राम विल से कॉमा इन्वर्टेड कॉमास बिगिन, राजन ब्रोक द ग्लास फुल स्टॉप कॉमा क्लोज. राम विल से दैट, राजन ब्रोक द ग्लास. सो दीज आर द सेंटेंसेस एग्जाम्पल्स रिलेटेड टू द टॉपिक डायरेक्ट एंड इनडायरेक्ट. एंड इफ द रिपोर्टिंग वर्ब इज in present indefinite or future indefinite, then there is no change in the tense of reported speech. But if the reported verb is in past tense, the tense of the verb in the reported speech is changed, or the reported verb goes one step into the past simple to past simple. It means we will move one step from present to past. So if the reporting verb is in the past tense, the tense of the verb in the reported speech is changed. Here is the chart related to the reporting verb when it is in past and the change of the tense. First, present tense becomes past indefinite. Present continuous changes to past continuous. Present perfect becomes past perfect. Present perfect continuous becomes past perfect continuous. Past indefinite becomes past perfect. Shall or will or can or may changes into should or would or could or might plus verb's first form. Must, would, should, ought to, dare. There is no change in indirect speech when these modals are there. Past perfect and past perfect continuous. For past perfect and past perfect continuous, there is no change. So here is a chart related to the reporting verbs when the reporting verb is in the past tense. When reporting verb is in the past tense, then the tense of the verb in the reported speech is changed. So example, he said comma inverted commas begin, Rana writes a letter. He said that Rana wrote a letter. So when the reporting verb is in past, said, when the reporting verb is in the past, said, then the tense of the verb in the reported speech is changed. So here is a table. Go through this table, this rule, and we will continue with our sentences in our next topic, Now your duty is, now your work is to go through the given rules about narrations very well and remember this chart well. To memorize the chart, you must also memorize the rules of tense. For this narration, you must be memorized about the rules of tense. So to memorize the chart, you must also memorize the rules of tense. Thank you.